And down they come, thousands of green and gold balloons from the ceiling of the State Sports Centre. And with some of the colourful characters that get to the fights, as someone said, there'll be plenty of boys ducking in ringside as these go off.
It certainly will be. A green and gold of Australia. Jeff Fenwick fighting on the Australian colours tonight. And he looks as mean as they come. I've never seen him look meaner than that.
He does, Alan. I just see him. He walked over to the Japanese and glared straight at Shingaki. He didn't get a response from Shingaki, but I'm sure he will shortly.
I tell you what, when that first balloon went off, Alan, I saw three colourful racing identities dive under the seat.
Can we say who they are?
No.
Okay.
Jeff Fenwick, eight stone, 5.5 pounds of street-born meanness. And I've never seen him looking meaner. He really wants to get on with us tonight. And let's go back now to our master of ceremonies, Ray Connolly.
Ladies and gentlemen, in conjunction with Chewy's Limited, Bill Morty's Classic Promotions attain the Fistic Peak of 1985. A contest scheduled for 15 three-minute rounds for the International Boxing Federation's Bantamweight Championship of the World between, from the red corner, scaling 8 stone 5 pounds, wearing blue trunks with white band and pipings, from Lara City, Japan, former holder of the crown he now covets, and now challenging for that title, Satoshi Shingaki. And his opponent, occupying the blue corner, scaling 8 stone 5.5 pounds, wearing white trunks with red band and pipings, from Marrickville, Australia, in his initial defense of the title he captured exactly 4 months ago, Juggernaut Jeff Fenwick. Ringside judges from Tokyo, Japan, in his second year as an International Boxing Federation official, his fourth world championship, Takeo Sugimori. Entrusted with his initial responsibility at international level, Australia's John Wright. In his 19th year as an adjudicator, his 46th World Championship contest, from Las Vegas, the United States of America, Lou Tabbitt. Bringing to the ring the vast resources of 43 years experience, his 49th world title bout, a world record feat, from Florida, the United States of America, Jay Edson.
All right, now, who is the chief second for Team 4? You are. You're the chief second. Now, I went over the rules with you in the dressing room, but for the benefit of the audience, and again, I want to just do it again quickly. I want you to repeat what I say to Shingaki, because I don't want any problems to come up where he did not understand the command.
Yes.
When I say break, break. It's exactly what it means. If you don't, I will have to step in to help you. When I say punch out of it, punch out of it. One hand is free, you can still keep punching. I will, for your benefit, Mr. Shingaki, I will either say punch out of it or okay. You understand? Watch your low blows. Let's have a good fight. Shake hands. Good luck.
Most eloquently put by the referee tonight, Mr. Jay Edson from Florida.
Where's the timekeeper?
Mr. Edson now looking for the timekeeper. The man who's tonight refereeing his 49th world title fight. And what a cracker it should be as young Jeff Fenwick bounds out for round one in his first world title defense.
And he goes straight onto the attack, Fenwick, through the right hand in the first 4 seconds of the bout. Last time it went nine rounds. I don't think Jeff Fenwick would care for it to go nine here tonight.
See the Japanese extending his hand at the start of that round. It was really unnecessary for the Japanese to do that because they'd officially touched gloves before that, and I think Jeff did the right thing and threw the right hand straight away.
Well, he's going to let Shingaki know that he means business very early in the piece. Well, Shingaki said the last time he fought Fenwick and lost his title, he didn't fight the right fight. Well, what would be the right fight?
Well, as I said before, Alan, if I was in his corner, I'd be telling him to try and box, keep the right jab in Jeff's face and keep moving. But as I've also said before, it's very, very hard to keep away from Jeff Fenwick, believe me.
Well, John Farrell found that out in Brisbane when Fenwick really went after Farrell up then. He's going after Shingaki in the early part of the first round.
Beautiful, beautiful body puncher, Jeff Fenwick. I think he's hurt Shingaki already in this first round.
He certainly did. He hurt him with the right hand right over our commentary position. Shingaki, he winched. He got the right hand right flush on the nose. Fenwick missing with a wild right. He's looking supremely confident, Fenwick. He's looking the world champion. He's acting the part.
All right, hold. That's it. Punch out.
Punch on the break, the right hand from Shingaki.
Intriguing thing about Jeff Fenwick, Barry Mike, he doesn't seem to have the slightest problem with a southpaw.
No, he always boxes well against a southpaw, Mike. He's beautiful right hook in the body from Jeff Fenwick.
And Shingaki's sure bleeding from the nose already. That bleeding has come from the right hand in about the first 30 seconds of the fight over our commentary position. And that hurt Shingaki.
It certainly did, Alan. I think at the moment, left hook staggered from him. Jeff Fenwick. It shook him badly.
Well, Shingaki, he knew he was in for a tough fight, and Fenwick's let him know very early in the piece he's going to be in for a rough one. He's landed a couple of absorbing blows, and the nose of Shingaki is testimony to that.
At the moment, I think Shingaki will be having flashbacks to when he lost the title, and, you know, as I said, he realised that he's in with a terrier in there. He's in with the real champion, don't worry.
Left hand punching from Fenwick over towards our commentary spot, over to the neutral corner. Fenwick trying to line Shingaki up. He got him on the ropes, couple of left hands.
Keep him up,
says Jay Edson. Keep the punches up. They're back to centre ring. 20 seconds to go in the first round.
Sitting here at ringside, you can just feel the awesome power that Jeff Fenwick's got.
Left hand punching from Fenwick. Shingaki trying to go downstairs. With less than 10 seconds to go in the first round, Fenwick comfortably picking up the points in this first round. Shingaki bleeding from the nose over towards the neutral corner, and that's the end of round one.
The worst for pouring out of his nose after a fairly savage round one, and it must be very distressing and depressing, Barry Michael, to be up against a fellow like Fenwick who can whack.
Right, I mean,
he's got the punch of almost a welterweight, and you haven't got the punch yourself, because Shingaki really doesn't have the power of punch to worry Fenwick.
Well, that's it. I think Jeff found that out in their previous contest, and I think that he's going to no doubt make my prediction come true and win well within the sixth round on the evidence of that first round. I'll be surprised if he goes six, believe me.
Round two, Shingaki's trying to jab out that right hand. Doesn't look as though he's got a lot of power in his punches. Shingaki tries to be a little bit awkward. Fenwick not really going after Shingaki in the second round, the early part of the second round, having a good look at him, jabbing a left hand, hands held high.
I think Alan just realised that he's got the fight well in control already, and I think he's biding his time to land that big right hand or a big left hook.
Shingaki trying to take the fight up to Fenwick. Fenwick has got blood on his chest he's cut Shingaki in the eye. Shingaki's in trouble. The right hand from Fenwick staggered him. He's opened up a cut round about the right eye.
terrible cut on Shingaki's eye, blood streaming down the side of his face.
Fenwick has really given him something in the first two rounds. Left hand into the body.
Referee Jay Edson having a close look at Shingaki. I think he realised that if they can't do something with this cut at the end of the round, the fight could be over, believe me.
Fenwick has carved this Japanese up in two rounds here so far. Fenwick came out of the first into the first round, vicious. Shingaki on the ropes.
Shingaki is a mess. He's an absolute mess at the moment.
Oh, now Fenwick going after Shingaki over towards Jeff Fenwick's corner. Blood on his gloves, on his trunks, on his chest. Shingaki is an absolute mess. He's been cut above the right eye and in the nose. He's brave. He's game in the true Japanese tradition.
Shingaki's face looks like one of those ceremonial masks, except it's a mask of blood as it streams out of his right eye.
Right into the body from Fenwick.
This could be the end of this fight. If they can't do something with this cut in the corner, I think you'll see the bout terminate. It looks to be a very nasty cut.
It's a nasty cut, and not only is it nasty, he must have trouble seeing from the right eye, and Fenwick is just pounding his gloves into his face. Going after him now. Shingaki trying to fight back. And he does so.
I think it'll take a team of surgeons and some vets to fix that eye, Barry. I very much doubt whether a couple of cornermen can do it in the space of a minute between rounds.
Yes, Michael, they've really got a job ahead of them to try and stop this cut. I really wouldn't be surprised if this is the last round. I hate to say it because it's going to rob the fans of a more conclusive ending, but at the moment he's in a lot of trouble, Shingaki, believe me.
There's less than 8 seconds to go in the second round. I'm sure
with
Jay
Edson on his face, except that Shingaki's.
Edson no doubt will have a good look at the eye at the end of this round, but it's been all Fenwick, and that's round two.
Back they go to the corner, and the question, of course, must be asked now, can Shingaki continue with blood absolutely streaming down his face from a dreadful cut over the right eye? Overcomes the referee, Jay Edson.
Shingaki shaking his head, doctor having a look at the eye. You can see it there, it's right on the eyebrow. It's above his eye, which means the blood can trickle down
and referee
to impair his vision. No, we're going to box on in round three.
It'll be interesting to see if Jeff opens up the cut straight away. At the moment, they seem to have stemmed the flow of blood.
Well, it'll be a miracle if this eye holds up for even three or four rounds, let alone the distance of a world title fight. An evil cut right across the eyelid there, the right eyelid of Satoshi Shingaki is out. They come for round three.
And Fenwick looking very, very businesslike, looking mean. He's hurt Shingaki, he's opened him up.
He's treating Shingaki's punching power with complete disdain. Jeff knows it's just a matter of time, believe me, at the moment. He really knows that either he'll stop him on the cut or he'll knock him out. There's no way known the Japanese has got a prayer at the moment.
Well, you must really take heart with the courage of Shingaki. He could have easily turned it up at the end of the second round, but he's prepared to come out under very adverse conditions. The cut's opened up again, and he's in the true Japanese tradition, Shingaki, a fighter to the death.
He's a warrior, Alan. The Japanese are incredible like that. He'll give his best shot. He'll go down fighting, that's for sure.
We're in round three.
Shingaki wiping the blood away, and that must be starting to obscure his vision as it streams down over that right eye.
Yeah, it's intelligent, Fenwick, not to hold. He's got away from the fight just for a fraction. Edson gets well away from the fighters. He's a referee who scouts the outside of the ring. He doesn't believe in getting in too close. He thinks that he can get in there quick enough to stop things if they're not according to the rules. That was according to the rules. A right hand from Fenwick was an uppercut.
Beautiful.
Then he went downstairs. Shingaki in his own corner. Fighting back. Game as they come. Fenwick. Puts the shoulder into him, pushes him over towards the corner.
Staggers him. Beautiful work by Jeff.
Shingaki's in trouble.
Shingaki's in all sorts of trouble here. The third round.
But he comes back. He's an absolute mess, Satoshi Shingaki.
Jeff treating him with complete contempt at the moment. It's as easy as a gym spa for Jeff at the moment. His first world title defence.
Fenwick over towards the corner. Very much red on Fenwick, but it's the blood from Shingaki that's made him that way. Fenwick varying the punches, going downstairs. Look for the right, into the body. The left hand's got through the guard. Another left hand from Fenwick.
The uppercut was the punch that shook Shingaki earlier in the round. I think it's a punch that's just been working on, especially for this fight, Alan.
Well, he hasn't used it in his last couple, but he's got Shingaki in his own corner now. Shingaki trying to fight away, but he only runs into the gloves of Jeff Fenwick.
Making absolute mincemeat out of the Japanese in this third round, Alan. I think you've got to put your hands together for this Shingaki, because he's incredibly tough.
Six seconds to go in the round. In fact, there's less than six. That is round three.
His head. I very much doubt this will continue.
That's it.
Shingaki throws down the towel in disgust. The Japanese complaining again. But really, Shingaki had given more blood than the average blood donor would give in 12 months. A terrible sight. His eye was shockingly cut. Not only was his vision being obscured, but Barry Michael, I mean, permanent damage could have resulted. It was the only result.
Honestly, Mike, I think it's ridiculous from their corner to complain about that. Really terrible stuff to see managers and trainers want to let the boy go out. If I had been in his corner, it would have been over at the end of the second round, believe me.
Look at Shingaki shaping up to the referee. Silly fella, because he's been saved from considerable damage in the ring tonight. And he's disgusted, but by gee.
They've got to be kidding. Honestly, Mike, they've got to be kidding.
There's plenty of doctors would have stopped that around earlier, Barry.
I think so, Mike. It's a terrible cut. And besides the cut, Jeff was making absolute mincemeat out of Shingaki. It was only a matter of time before it was a conclusive knockout. I think the referee has done the right thing, no doubt, and the doctor.
And there he is, Australia's world champ Jeff Fenwick, his first defence, and he stopped the Japanese Satoshi Shingaki in three. Well, a glittering night indeed here at the State Sports Centre as promoter Bill Morty lets the glitter fall from the ceiling. First it was balloons. Now it was glitter, Barry Michael.
Incredible touch, Mike. It's the atmosphere here has been unbelievable tonight. What a great victory for Jeff Fenwick. I've never, ever seen him look so good, Mike.
No, he was into him right from that opening second, wasn't he? And first his nose started to bleed, then his eyes started to bleed, and from that point on he became a mere punching bag.
He was just a punching bag. The Japanese, a typical warrior, wanted to go on, but I think it would have been sheer stupidity. He had didn't have a snowball's chance in hell of winning this fight.
And now your master of ceremonies, Ray Connolly.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Bill Weiderberg will adorn the champion with the belt that was made possible by Chewy's Limited and Bill Morty's Classic Promotions, and provided in its design and construction by Australia's ballpoint king, Brian O'Connor.
And there he is, Jeff Fenwick, the king of the kids. They love him and he loves them. And he's being presented with yet another belt. I must say, belts are a source of inconvenience to me, Barry. I have trouble doing them up. Jeff's got two beauties.
That's beautiful, that new belt that Jeff's got. They really look terrific and fully deserved by Jeff Fenwick tonight. An absolutely brilliant career. Brilliant victory for him.
Well, they're already interested in him in the United States, and here's a fella who's had 10 fights, 10 knockout victories, the ultimate record in boxing, and he just keeps getting better and better. Jeff Fenwick, with him in the ring, Alan Thomas.
Okay, Jeff Fenwick, 4 months ago you took the title here under what was controversial circumstances, but tonight you left no doubt that you are the world champ.
Well, Alan, a few months ago I did win the world title. I thought it was fair and square. So I had something to prove tonight. I was mean and hungry tonight. I'm sure going to just say again, Satoshi Shingaki is just so tough, what can I say about him? He's just a true challenger again, but like I said, this belt's mine and nobody's taking it off me, nobody.
What about the cut to Shingaki? Left hook, was it, in the second round?
Well, I'm not real sure. I just tried to work off the jab and I think everything was going to fall into place. I think this time, I'm a little bit unhappy that the fight stopped because I had made a few promises to myself that Satoshi was going to make a few trips to the canvas this time so he could remember Australia well, but well, that's the way it goes, but I think he'll remember it anyway.
You must admire the man's courage by the same token. He could have easily given it away at the end of the second round.
Yeah, like I said, Alan, he's surely not short on courage, but like I said earlier, I'm improving, I'm going to keep on improving, and thanks again, Bill Morty, and thanks everybody for coming to the stadium, and I'll just prove to all you Australians when I take on the American Jerome Coffey that I'm the best bantamweight in the world.
All right.
There he is, Jeff Fenwick with his faithful mate Con.
That's the word for
ring,
Jeff Fenwick
successfully defended his IBF bantamweight title. First time knockout in three rounds, or he stopped the Japanese Satoshi Shingaki, who suffered a shockingly cut eye. Congratulations to Jeff. We'll be back live here at the State Sports Centre in just a moment. It was, just another devastating round for Fenwick. This was the third and final round.
The cuts actually concluded the fight, Mike, but it was only a matter of time before Shingaki visited the canvas. He was badly shaken on a number of occasions. I noticed this time he didn't take the punches from Jeff as well as he did in the previous fight. And, there's no doubt Jeff would have knocked him out.
Yes, his defences were gone. That cut above the right eye was obviously hindering his vision. Not only couldn't he see, but there was grave chance of permanent danger, damage to that eye. And that's why the doctor unhesitatingly said, no, that's it. Up there in the ring with the referee, the man who called the doctor in, Jay Edson, we have Alan Thomas.
Referee Jay Edson, who officially stopped the fight, Jay? Was it yourself or the doctor?
I called the doctor and asked his opinion. He said it's a deep cut, which I could see myself. And he said, I don't think it should go on. He asked my opinion. I agreed with him. I would have stopped it myself sometime in the next round if that blood continued to flow into the eye and onto the gloves. I wanted to make sure that the Japanese fighter had every opportunity to fight. He was fighting. As far as I didn't see the other fight, I don't know what happened. But in this fight, he was defending himself. He was punching back. I had no reason to stop it as far as effort goes. I did have reason to stop it because that cut was at least an eighth of an inch wide. I could practically see the bone tissue above his eye. So it should go into the record book that the doctor stopped the fight.
Did you give consideration to stopping it at the end of the second round?
I asked the doctor at that time. He said, let's try it for one more round.
All right. Jay Edson, who refereed tonight's world title fight here at the Homebush Centre.
Thanks, Alan. Jay Edson, a man who's refereed over 3,500 bouts. Tonight was his 49th world title. He knows what it's all about. And as he said, he would have stopped it next round anyway. The Japanese was copping such a sustained battering. At the State Sports Centre, we'll be back with more in just a moment. That cut on the side of his head.